Hey everyone, here's a quick tip for limiting the number of quiz attempts in a Storyline 360 project. So by default, the way the quizzing works is if you add the retry button, right, to your result slide, it's going to reset all of the current scores and results and let the learner retry the quiz from scratch. That's totally cool. That's the way it's intended. But maybe you want to put a limit to the number of times they can actually attempt that quiz. Pretty simple to do. We just need to add a custom variable with to act as a counter so we can count the number of tries or number of attempts they've had on the quiz. And here's how that works. So we want to come over here to the triggers panel, to the project variables panel and create a new variable. So we'll just call this quiz attempts. And it needs to be a number variable because we do want to count the number of tries, so number. And the default value at 0 is totally fine. Click OK, and then we'll click OK one more time. All right, so the way this works is each time the learner sees this particular slide, and it's actually a layer in this template library, right? This template file is a failure layer. Don't have to worry about the success because if they pass it, then they don't really need to worry about taking it again. So we're all in the failure layer right here. Every time they get to this layer, it means they failed the test, and the retry button is going to present itself. So what we could do is probably just add the trigger right here that acts as the trigger to adjust that variable. That's going to count the number of tries they've had. So we do that by coming over to the triggers panel, and we'll create a new trigger that says adjust variable, and the variable that we want to adjust is the one we just created, the quiz attempts, and we want to add a value of 1 each time they click that button, right? So each time they click the retry, it's essentially letting them try again, and then we're going to count that try. So click OK. Notice how down here, though, because it's the third trigger in the order, we've got the reset results, easy for me to say, jump to slide, and now the counter is down here. We want to move this one up because what will happen is since triggers are fired from top to bottom, when they get to this trigger, when Storyline gets to this trigger, it's going to jump to that slide and never have time to add that variable. So I want to select this, use the arrow button to move it up to the very top. All right, cool. So we need one more trigger here that evaluates whether or not this counter is equal to a certain value. And so when it equals a certain value, what we want to do is prevent the learner from being able to click it. What we could do is just use the disabled state, right? So just use a disabled state, which means the button will be visible, but they won't be able to click it. We could hide it. We could put another button on top of it, but disabled works enough, you know, well enough for this example, so that's fine. So we want to change this button state to disabled when the counter, let's say, equals 2. That means they've had 3 attempts at the quiz. Now, before we get too far, what we should do is add a variable reference for quiz attempts just so we can see how many times that value has been changed, and also lets us troubleshoot the quiz to let us know that, hey, you know, this is working or this isn't working. And the way we work with variable references is by going up to insert text box and just add a empty blank text box to your slide, come back up here to the insert tab, and we want to choose a reference. And reference just means the value of that variable. So we want to put quiz attempts as the reference, and because that text is light, we need to make that dark, we need to make it light. It'll show the value of each time it counts the tries. All right, so that's going to be super helpful for us to verify that things are working or not working. Next up, let's go ahead and add that trigger for the slide that changes the state of the retry button from normal to disabled if the quiz attempts is equal to a specific value. Do that by adding a new trigger, and we want to change the state. What do we want to do? We want to change the state of the retry button, and we want to change it to disabled when the timeline starts. So what's happening is when the slide loads, the timeline starts. So when we come back into the slide after we finish the second multiple choice question, we want Storyline to check in and see if that variable's changed. And we do that by adding a condition that says change it to disabled and only if this condition has been met. And that condition is the variable quiz attempts is equal to, in this case, 2. And this will be the number that you can easily change. So you won't have to, if you want to modify this or use this different ways for different, you know, attempts, all you need to do is change this one number and you can do that. You won't have to rebuild it every time. So click OK and click OK. So that looks pretty good. Let's go ahead and preview our project. All right, so there's just our welcome screen. We'll click next to get through this. You can see where the correct choice is. I'm just going to select any one of these. One more. Submit. All right, cool. So here's the result slide. I just took the quiz one time. It shows zero. When I click retry, I would expect to see this thing be this number update to one the next time I get there. Oh, and you might have even seen it change real quick as we were jumping back to this new slide. So go through it one more time. Okay, so now it's at one, and remember, after two, it's going to disable this. So I've already taken the quiz two times. I'm going to take it one more time, which is the third time, and I'll continue to get it incorrect. All right, cool. And there it is. The number is two, and our retry button is now disabled, so I'm not able to go forward. You could include a little note that says, hey, you ran out of tries. No more attempts, no more tries on the test. Go ahead and click the next button and move through the course. But that's how easy it is to disable that retry button to limit the number of quiz attempts in Storyline 360.